It's translucent, sterile, amber-colored, and generated in part by your kidneys. Yeah, we're talking about your urine, and I'm here to tell you that you're flushing secrets about your health straight down the drain. We can learn so much about you just with a cup of pee. When you think of a urine test, you probably think about drug and pregnancy tests. Pregnancy tests measure the human chorionic gonadotropin, or HCG, that's a hormone produced only while you're pregnant. And common drug tests, they're looking for the presence of bits of multiple drugs in a panel deemed the SAMHSA5. But those are just two testing methods. There are over 3,000 different compounds in your urine. 3,000! Think of all the things that we could learn. Currently, we know that pee is a pretty good gauge of what's going on in your urinary system on a basic level. I'm sure you've peed in a cup or two over the years when you go to the doctor, and it's not just to prove that you don't have stage fright. Pee is 95% water and metabolites, but the rest could be things like glucose, ketone bodies, nitrites, proteins, and hormones. That's just a few things. However, we're not really supposed to find a lot of these compounds in your pee. High glucose could indicate diabetes, proteins could be chronic kidney disease, and any nitrites are likely a urinary tract infection. But doctors are also scanning your pee for a few other key, obvious things: volume, color, and odor. Volume could tell doctors how hydrated or not you are. Color could indicate if someone's kidneys are functioning properly. And cloudy urine, that could mean a UTI. A very strong odor could mean a serious infection. Now, that might seem like a lot of stuff already, but remember, we're working with 3,000 compounds here. Scientists don't want to let this waste go to waste. And they're working on detecting something else: gastrointestinal cancer. The metabolites in our pee could help us do that. Metabolites are the chemical byproducts that our cells make during metabolism. Since cells come from different locations in the body and are affected by energy and nutrient intake differently, their metabolites can tell us a lot about our environmental interactions. The scientists basically used these as biomarkers for any disease or cancers in our GI tract. And it worked. GI cancers altered the metabolic signatures, and it's all reflected there in our pee for us to see. More research is obviously needed, but this could be a game changer. We could stray away from costly and invasive cancer screenings and start preventative care where all you gotta do, pee in that cup. So, pee can't tell us direct answers, but the information hiding in our pee hints at what the bigger picture is inside of us. We've come a long way from just flushing all the good information-rich urine down the toilet. Now we can really understand how we can utilize this gross resource to benefit us all. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. We may be finding cancers in our pee, but porcupines are using it in a whole different way. Check it out on Wild Sex here. Fun fact, the average human generates up to 2 liters of urine a day, meaning over a lifetime, you could fill a small backyard swimming pool. Gross. Thanks for watching.